Hello students, welcome to CS Academy platform to listen best lectures every day with a different approach of answering for mechanical and civil students. Okay, in this session we will discuss the most important topic in fluid mechanics subject, that is, out of laminar and turbulent flows, which flow is better? Okay, and if the turbulent flow is better, what is the reason? Or if the laminar flow is better, what is the reason? Okay, we will learn this flow betterness in this session. Please watch this session till the end. You will get a better idea than the previous. Okay. If I ask this question to students, many students, like 50 to 60% students, will that laminar flow is better. Okay. But if I ask the question, what is the reason why laminar flow is better than the turbulent flow, means they don't answer. They don't know exactly the reason. Okay. And if I ask the question like, in which flow the energy loss is more? If I ask this question to many students, they will tell that in turbulent flow energy loss is more. Okay, but it is not correct. Exactly for a laminar and turbulent flow, in both flows the energy loss may exist. Okay, in both flows the energy loss may exist. But why students are thinking that in turbulent flow energy loss is more? Okay, it is not correct, and I will tell the reason in this session. Okay, and out of the laminar and turbulent flow, mostly we will prefer laminar flow. Okay, the reason behind is not because of energy loss is less in the laminar flow. Okay, listen carefully. The reason why we are preferring a laminar flow than the turbulent flow means, it is not the reason because of energy loss is less in the turbulent laminar flow. Okay, the reason behind why we are preferring laminar flow than the turbulent flow means, here we can easily predict the energy loss. Okay, we can easily predict the energy loss here. Okay, and here in turbulent flow we cannot easily predict this energy loss here. The prediction here means not only the energy loss but also the pumping power requirements. Like let us consider, to understand this one clearly, let us consider I am considering one pipe here, and here I am sending the liquid, some liquid from the section 1 to section 2 like this. Okay, let us consider the pipe at the inlet, the energy of this fluid having 20 kilojoules. Let's consider here, and at outlet whatever we require the energy should be processed by the fluid, that should be 10 kilojoules. Let us consider after neglecting the losses here. Okay, we want 10 kilojoules at the outlet, but we are sending the fluid with 20 kilojoules of energy. But in laminar flow, the energy loss we are predicting here, that is the 10 kilojoules of energy is losing in this fluid whenever we are sending from the one section to other section. But if we consider the turbulent flow, the energy loss may vary like 10 kilojoules or 15 kilojoules or 13 kilojoules, whatever it may be. We cannot predict in the turbulent flow. That means there are no such mechanisms to calculate the energy loss in the turbulent flow. That is, here you can conclude that in laminar flow and turbulent flow, there exists energy loss in the both cases. Yes or no? But the reason why the energy loss is taking place in the laminar and turbulent flow is the mechanism is different between this laminar and turbulent. That is, if we consider the laminar flow, the mechanism of energy loss here is like a friction or viscosity. Because of the viscosity or friction, the energy loss is taking place in the laminar flow. If we consider turbulent flow, because of disorderness of fluid flow, or this zigzag motion, because of this zigzag or disorderness of the fluid, the energy loss taking place in the turbulent flow. Okay, and here you have to understand that the energy loss is taking place in the both laminar and turbulent, and we are preferring the laminar flow. It is not because of the reason of energy loss is less. Many students think that energy loss is less in the laminar flow, that's why we are considering this laminar flow, but it is not the reason. Okay, the reason behind it is, in laminar flow we can easily predict how much energy is losing taking place in this fluid system, and whatever we are requiring this energy, that we can easily send from the inlet to the outlet by predicting the loss of energy. But in case of turbulent flow, we cannot predict. It may be 10 or 15 or 13. Okay, that means the requirement of the energy at outlet we can't get exactly, so that we are preferring the laminar flow when compared with the turbulent flow. Okay, if you see the differences between laminar and turbulent, in this laminar flow the fluid flows in a well defined manner. that is without any collisions, without any interactions between these two layers. In laminar flow, the fluid flow like a well-defined manner, that is ordered flow. Ordered flow. If we see in turbulent flow, it is a zigzag manner, like this, it will flow somewhere like this. They will collide with each other's layer, that is a zigzag motion. Zigzag motion, okay. And we can also call it as a smooth flow, okay. Fluid flow like smoothly, and here it is a mixed flow, okay. And here it is a mixed flow. And if you see the mechanism, the losing of energy in laminar flow, that is because of viscosity. And here if you see in turbulent case, the loss because of a mixed or a zigzag motion, okay. Because of mixed or a zigzag motion. Let us consider to understand the laminar and turbulent flow, the best example is like, let us consider there is a one school here, and students are coming to school in a well-defined manner, in a QQ form, yes or no? This is like a laminar flow. And in turbulent flow, the best example here is the same here. Let us consider the school is here, and if the students are allowed to play the games, how they will go? They will go like a random manner, yes or no? We can't guess whether student A or B, where they are present. Yes or no? That means it is a zigzag motion. Okay? And one more example here, let us consider there is a one tap like this. There is a one tap. And just I opened a small opening here, and the water will come like this. The water will come like this. See? Like this. The water will come like this, and the flow is like a linear flow. Okay? That is ordered flow. The fluid will come very slowly in a smooth manner or ordered flow. Okay. In the same situation, the pipe is there, and if I open this valve fully open, what will happen? The fluid will come like this in a zigzag manner. We can't predict whether the fluid is flowing to this side or this side or this side like this. Yes or no? This is a turbulent flow best example. This is the laminar flow best example. Okay. And if I ask you one scientist name for this laminar flow, it is Newton, and the law is Newton's law of viscosity here. And if I ask you for the turbulent flow, it is nothing but of Reynolds. Okay. And here we know the Newton's law of viscosity, that is tau equal to mu into du by dy. It is purely depends upon the viscosity, and that is nothing but of laminar flow. And here Reynolds is the scientist who made his about experiments on the turbulent, and finally he got on calculation non-dimensional numbers, that is Reynolds number, that is rho v d by mu. Okay, based upon this non-dimensional number, we will predict that whether the flow is laminar or turbulent. Here this is the density of the fluid, and this is the average velocity of the fluid, and the diameter of the fluid pipe. And this is the viscosity of the fluid. Okay. If this Reynolds number is less than 2000, that flow is nothing but of a laminar flow. Okay, laminar flow. If the Reynolds number is greater than 4000, the flow is nothing but of a turbulent flow. Okay. If the Reynolds number is in between 2000 and 4000, we will call it as a transition flow. Transition is nothing but of, it is the transition from the laminar to turbulent. Okay. Like this, if you see the relation between Reynolds number and the velocity and diameter, the Reynolds number is directly proportional to average velocity of the fluid, and it is directly proportional to diameter of the fluid pipe. Yes or no? To maintain the laminar flow, what we have to do means the velocity of the fluid should be very low, and the diameter of the pipe should be very low. Yes or no? And why we are maintaining the Reynolds number is very less means, here we know the loss here in laminar flow, we can easily predict the losses, or we can easily predict whatever may be the pumping power losses like this. Okay, but in turbulent flow we cannot predict, and that's why we are not using this turbulent flow. So that for our general purpose we are using the laminar flow, so that for laminar flow Reynolds number is very less. For that, to maintain the Reynolds number is very less, we should maintain a very low velocity, and the diameter is very low. Yes or no? And if you see the best example fluids for the laminar and turbulent flow, for laminar flow the best fluid is that is honey or castor oil like this, and for turbulent flow the fluids like water we can use for the turbulent flow. Okay, and one more reason why we are preferring this laminar flow means, let us consider the distribution of velocity in laminar flow like this. Let us consider this is the pipe, a fluid flowing from this one side to other side, and the velocity distribution is like a parabolic in the laminar flow like this, and this is the velocity distribution. Okay, and if you see, this is the center of this pipe. If you want to find the velocity at any section from this point in laminar flow, we can use the velocity distribution at any radial distance from the center to outside. We can use that minus 1 by 4 mu into dou p by dou x into capital R square minus small r square. This is the capital R radius from the center to outside. And if you want to find the this velocity at this point, that is a small r, we can find with the help of this equation in the laminar flow. But in case of turbulent flow, we cannot predict the velocity distribution. And we cannot predict the velocity at a certain distance from this radius, from the center to outside. And this is the one of the reason, this is one of the other reason why we are preferring this laminar flow when compared with the turbulent flow. Okay, I hope you got the point from this session, why we are preferring this laminar flow when compared with this turbulent flow. It is not the reason that laminar flow, the loss is very less and turbulent flow loss is very high. It's not the reason. Okay, in both cases, laminar and turbulent flow losses are there. But the losses we are predicting in case of laminar flow, and we are not predicting in case of turbulent flow. Okay, that is the reason why we are preferring this laminar flow. Okay, I hope you got the point. And this is a very best question in case of interviews also, and in APBSC, AWS, like this question will ask in the exams. And please go through this session. And thank you for watching my video. Thank you.